Hi students, welcome back. We are in chapter 4, Animal Kingdom, and this is part 1 video. Coming to Kingdom Animalia, the classification helps in easy identification and also in assigning a systematic position to newly described species. So millions of species of animals have been described, and it becomes more necessary to classify them to assign a systematic position. So the animals have to be classified based on some features so that we can understand the animals better. So animals are classified on the basis of arrangement of cells, body symmetry, nature of coelom, pattern of digestive, circulatory and reproductive system. This is the flow chart in which we can understand how the animal kingdom has been classified based on the features. They are classified on the levels of organization, be it cellular level, tissue level, organ level and organ system level. In the cellular level, each comprises of the animals which is having a simple cellular system and it has a porifera. And coming to tissue or organ or in the organ system level, they constitute the other animals present in the animal kingdom, and each can be further divided based on the symmetry. If it is radially symmetrical, they are kept under Coelenterata and Ctenophora, and if they are bilaterally symmetrical, they are kept under other groups. These bilaterally symmetrical animals are further classified based on their presence of body cavity into acoelomates, pseudocoelomates and coelomates. So acoelomates consist of platyhelminthes and pseudocoelomates consist of ascalemintus, and coelomates consist of annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata and chordata. Coming to levels of organization, the levels of organization can be of cellular level, tissue level, organ level and organ system level. So based on the cellular level, they can be classified into phylum Porifera, which includes the sponges. The body shows some division of labor among cells and they are remarkably independent and can change their form and function. The body consists of many cells that are arranged loosely and the cell aggregates, but the cells do not form tissues. They only have cells and they do not form tissues, and rather each cell functionally active independently. Example is Hydra. And coming to the tissue level of organization, the cells were performing the same function or arranged into tissue. A group of cells having the definite functions are called as tissues, and it is called as tissue level of organization. And the example is Coelenterates. The arrangement of cells is more complex than that of the phylum Porifera. Coming to the organ level, in Platyhelminthes and other higher phyla, tissues are grouped together to form organs. So the tissues with the definite functions are grouped together to form an organ, and they have a particular function. That is called as organ level of classification. And coming to organ system level, in animals like annelids, arthropods, molluscs and echinoderms and chordates, organs have associated to form functional system. That functional system is called as organ system, and this is called as organ system level of organization. This is seen in the higher animals. And coming to the organ system of system level of classification, they can be incomplete digestive system which has one opening. So if there is a one opening in the digestive system, then it is called as incomplete. If it has two opening, then it is called as complete digestive system. This two opening is mouth and anus. Whereas in incomplete digestive system, there is only one opening is there. Coming to open circulatory system, blood is pumped out of the heart and cells and tissues are directly bathed in it. So in the open circulatory system, there is no arteries, veins and capillaries to carry the blood. Instead, the blood is pumped and the tissues and the other cells are bathed by the blood. So in the closed circulatory system, it has a definite organ to carry the blood, that is the arteries, veins and capillaries. So it is circulated through them. So they are closed circulatory system. This is about the levels of organization. Coming to symmetry. Symmetry refers to the arrangement of parts on the opposite sides of the body of a three-dimensional animal. And based on symmetry, the animals can be classified into asymmetrical and symmetrical. Asymmetrical animals are those which cannot be divided into any equal half. So they are called as asymmetrical. Example is amoeba and sponges. They don't have a definite shape, so it cannot be divided into an equal half. So they are not symmetrical. They are called as asymmetrical. Coming to symmetrical, it can be further divided into radially symmetrical and bilaterally symmetrical. Radially symmetrical, they can be divided into equal halves by any plane passing through the center. So this Hydra C, all the planes passing through the center can divide the organism into equal halves. So it is radially symmetrical. Whereas in bilaterally symmetrical, it can be divided halves by only one plane. One plane can divide the animal into two halves. Then it is called as bilaterally symmetrical. Most of the higher animals, vertebrates, are bilaterally symmetrical. See here the sponges, which is a lower animal, they are asymmetrical. They don't have a definite symmetry. Coming to diploblastic and triploblastic organization. So diploblastic means they have only endoderm and ectoderm, whereas triploblastic they have endoderm, ectoderm and mesoderm. The animals in which cells are arranged in two embryonic layers, external ectoderm and internal endoderm, are called diploblastic. Example, porifera and nidaria. In porifera and nidaria, only two embryonic layers are seen, two germ layers are seen. They are ectoderm and the endoderm. Ectoderm is the outer layer and endoderm is the inner layer. Whereas in animals in which developing embryo has a third germinal layer, mesoderm, besides ectoderm and endoderm, are called triploblastic. Higher animals are triploblastic in nature and they have an extra germ layer that is called as mesoderm, which is present in the middle of ectoderm and endoderm. So this is the diploblastic and triploblastic. Here only ectoderm and endoderm is there, whereas in the triploblastic animal, mesoderm is present, the third germ layer. Coming to coelom. Coelom is the body cavity. The body cavity which is lined by mesoderm is called as coelom. Animals possessing coelom are called coelomate. So the animals containing coelom are called as coelomate, and examples are annelida, chordates and mollusca. In some animals, cavity is not lined by mesoderm but scattered as pouches in between ectoderm and endoderm. They are called as pseudocoelomates. Example is Ascalimentus. The animals in which body cavity is absent are called acoelomate, that is Platyhelminthus. So the animals which contain the mesodermal lining in their body cavity is called as coelomates, and the animals which contains mesoderm lining in pouches which are scattered in the body cavity, then it is called as pseudocoelomate. The animals which do not contain that mesodermal lining in the body cavity is called as acoelomate. So the example for acoelomate is Platyhelminthus, and example for pseudocoelomate is Ascalimentus, whereas other higher animals contain coelom. Coming to body plan, animals can be classified on basis of body plan. On basis of body plan, animals are classified into three types. They are cell aggregate plan, in which the cells are aggregated and they are not formed into tissues or organ. Example is sponges. This we have already seen in the cellular level of organization. This is a phylum Porifera, in which the cells are not aggregated. They are just grouped and they don't form into a tissue. And blind sac plan, in which the cells are organized into tissues. Single opening of the body for ingestion and digestion. It is a incomplete digestive system in which only one opening is there for both ingestion and digestion. Example is coelenterates and flatworm. Tube within a tube plan. It is a level of organization in organ system, and proper digestive canal is present having two openings. So only we call it as tube within a tube, one for ingestion and another for digestion. So it has two openings and it is a complete digestive system. So one opening is for ingestion and one opening is for egestion, and it is a organ system level of classification. It occurs in two way, that is protostomes and neutrostomes. In protostomes, the mouth develops from blastopore region and anus develops later. So during the embryonic development stage, first the mouth is developed and then the anus is developed. So example is annelids, molluscus and arthropoda. Coming to deuterostomes, anus develops first during the embryonic development and the mouth develops later. Example is echinoderms and cortex, which are the higher animals. Coming to segmentation. Segmentation is the division of body both externally and internally. It is seen in annelids, arthropods and cortex. Segmentation, it is dividing both internally and externally, then it is called as metamerism, and it is called as metaboric segmentation. And if the segmentation is not true, if the body is divisible into parts or segments called proglottids and developed from neck but are not embryonic in origin, such a repetition appears due to repeated budding and is known as false segmentation or pseudometamerism. So it is seen in tapeworm. Here we can see that this is not a segment, it is a budding which is attached to one another. So there it is a repetitive budding and it appears to be a segment. So it is a pseudo metamerism, whereas in earthworm the segments are both internal and external, and these segments are called as somites, and this is called as metamerism, in which the body is divided both internally and externally by into segments. Coming to notochord. Notochord is a primitive beginning of the backbone. It appears in embryos as a small flexible rod made from cells from the mesoderm, which is one of the three layers of cells of embryos. So from the three germinal layer, the notochord arrives from the mesoderm. Notochords are only found in the phylum Chordata, a group of animals that includes humans. So the phylum Chordata is classified based on the presence of notochord. The notochord is oriented head to tail and is found between the digestive tube and the nerve cord. So this is the presence of notochord in the embryonic development stage. It is derived from the mesoderm. Since it is composed of stiffer tissue, it allows for skeletal support of the organism. In certain chordates like the lamprey and the sturgeon, the notochord remains there for life. So in some animals, this notochord remains for life, but in higher animals like humans, this notochord develops into the vertebral column. Such as humans, a more complex backbone appears with only portions of the notochord remaining. As our backbone fully forms, the discs in our back is where the pieces of notochord are formed as a sort of gelatinous material. Those animals which do not form their structure are called non-chordates, example Porifera to Echinoderms. So the phylum from Porifera to Echinoderms doesn't contain notochords. The notochords containing animals are called grouped under phylum Chordata, and the animals that do not contain the notochord are called as non-chordates. Based on other important features, animal kingdom can also be classified. What are they? Cephalization. It is a differentiation of head and anterior part of the body. It involves the concentration of nervous tissue and sense organs in the head. Coming to the second one, it is the appendages. It is a extra or external organs. Extra external organs. It is a projecting structure of the body that performs specific functions like locomotion, capturing of food, sensation, etc. And they are called as appendages. Examples are wings, fins, limbs, tentacles, parapodia, setae, etc. And coming to the sex organs, based on the presence of sex organs, the animals can be classified into monoecious and dioecious. In the monoecious animals, both the male and female sex organs are present in the same individual, and they are called as hermaphrodite or bisexual or monoecious. Example is tapeworm and earthworm. dioecious animals with either male or female sex organ. One individual will be having only one sex organ, whether either it will be male or it will be female sex organ, and it is known as unisexual or dioecious. Example is frog, lizards, birds, human, etc. Fourth one is reproduction. Based on the mode of reproduction, animals can be classified. Asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction takes place. Mostly, animals reproduce through sexual reproduction. In lower animals only, asexual reproduction takes place. Asexual reproduction is found in lower animals, and the common methods are budding, fission, fragmentation and regeneration. Budding is seen in Hydra, and regeneration and fragmentation is seen in Planaria, that is Platyhelminthes. And sexual reproduction, it is seen in most of the animals. All the higher animals undergo sexual reproduction, and it involves fusion of male and female gametes. The male gamete is sperm and the female gamete is ova. Coming to the fertilization, fertilization can take place in two methods, that is external fertilization and internal fertilization. If the fusion of male and female gamete occurs externally in the external media, that is outside the body, then it is called as external fertilization, and it is seen in many invertebrates, some marine fishes and most amphibians, example frog. In internal fertilization, it occurs in land animals and some aquatic animals, in which the sperms are introduced by the male into the reproductive tract of a female during copulation. So it happens in higher animals like mammals. With this, we close the topic for this video. In the next video, we will see about the different phyla that comes under animal kingdom. Okay, children, we will meet on the part 2 video. Thank you.